What's up, guys? I'm going to show you how you can take your video from this and improve it to this. So let's get started. So one of the first steps you can do is to give your footage a distinct look and style. This is called color grading. I want this video to have a more dramatic and dark look to it. I feel like the original footage straight out of the camera just doesn't give me that look. So what I can do is select the clip I want to change. Now I have the option of opening up the advanced color tuning tool, which can be found here. Once that is open, you can see that I have a bunch of options to alter the clip, changing things like the white balance, exposure, contrast and saturation will allow me to have custom control over the look of the footage. Or you can simply add a 3D LUT to your video, which will automatically apply a distinct look to your clip, which is exactly what I'm going to do. So I'm going to select the 3D LUT tab and choose one of the available LUTs. Each LUT has a different look, so you can play around and choose different ones to see which one you like, but I'm just going to go ahead and stick with Mission Impossible. Now I'm going to hit OK, and the LUT will be applied to my clip in the timeline. So if you want the rest of your clips to have the same LUT applied to them, then you will need to open up the Advanced Color Tuning Tool for each individual clip and apply the LUT that way. So to really dial up that intensity from the gun shootout, I'm going to use an effect from the Blockbuster set. You can purchase your own copy of the Blockbuster effects set at filmora.wondershare.com/effects store. There is a link in the description box below. So if I go ahead and click on Elements, then click on Blockbuster on the left side of the screen, I can open up all the elements in the Blockbuster set. In order to make the gunshots more believable, I'm going to use the elements called Bullets 22 and 23. These are called muzzle flashes, and I'm going to overlay them on the video every time someone fires a gun. I have 19 muzzle flashes laid out on my timeline in this video, so for the sake of time, I'm only going to show you two examples. One that uses a camera angle looking directly at the gun, and one from the side. You can follow these steps and repeat them for any other gunshots you have in your own videos. So in this clip, the camera is looking at the gun from the front as it is being fired. So I'm going to drag and drop bullets 23 onto a picture-in-picture track on my timeline. The muzzle flash only shows up for one frame, so I want to place it at a point when it looks like the trigger is being pulled. Now once I have it in the correct spot on the timeline, I need to resize and reposition it. I can do that by making sure the muzzle flash element is selected, and then grabbing one of the corners of the yellow bounding box and dragging it inwards. Once I have it down to the size that I want, I can reposition it by clicking somewhere inside the yellow bounding box and dragging it. I'm going to place it somewhere over the middle of the barrel of the gun. If I play it back, you can see that I have a muzzle flash that makes the gunshot look more dramatic. Now I'm going to show you how to apply a muzzle flash when your camera footage looks at the gun from the side. So in this clip, I'm going to drag and drop bullets 22 on one of my picture-in-picture track layers. The first problem you can see is that the muzzle flash is facing the wrong way. This can be corrected by selecting the muzzle flash clip and clicking on the green screen tool. If you look on the left side down near the bottom, you will see a tab that says flip. Click on that and you will see the option to rotate or flip your clip. I'm going to click on flip horizontal so that the muzzle flash faces the correct way. Then hit OK and it will update in the timeline. Now I can do the same thing I did with the last muzzle flash. I will resize it by grabbing the edge of the yellow bounding box, and then I will click and drag inside the yellow bounding box to reposition it just out in front of the gun. Now you would just have to repeat these steps every time someone pulls the trigger on the gun, and you will have a sequence full of dramatic gunshots. One last thing you can do is add overlays. One popular technique is adding a letterbox. This is when you see those black bars on the top and bottom of a video. This is meant to create an aspect ratio that resembles the type of cameras that are used to film big budget Hollywood movies. Once you have imported the letterbox into Filmora, you can simply drag and drop it onto a picture-in-picture track layer and stretch it out to cover the entire video. Make sure to keep it on the lowest picture-in-picture track, that way it will sit over top of all the other layers that you place in your timeline. Also, check out Filmora's filters and overlays section. You might find some graphics that can be handy in your action film. At the beginning of this video, I used a heads-up display from the sci-fi set. Thanks so much for watching! Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and have fun making your own action films.